introduction and this core from this, and also we also provide development tools to help customize your own instructions, so you can do domain specific acceleration very easily. I'm Tommy from Andes Technology. Okay, so let's our product overview. We decide to start from our extension to RISC-V ISR. And we also do microarchitecture designs and implement RISC-V compliant CPUs and do our own IDE tools, software stacks, and also provide evaluation platforms to help you evaluate and also develop your solutions. So let's line up about this RISC-V course. We start from a 5-stage pipelines and 12 family, and it's capable with APU support, and also there are coming cores with DSP extension support. And for A series is 25 or 64 bits AX25. It's capable to run Linux, and also have the capability of almost all features like MMU, DSP, APU, and also you can customize your own instructions. And for the multi-core version, you can config your system from one core and to four cores. So we also provide entry-level N22 with 2-stage pipeline, smaller, but it can run at a very high frequency at 800 megahertz. So what's the difference about and this RISC-V cores to others? The first, we use the ISR from foundations, and we also put and this unique features and instruction extensions into our CPU. So there are some more than baselines, like you can speed up some help to speed up memory access, some help to speed up branches, and also improve core density. So you can treat it as a superset to the foundation's ISR. Still keep compatibility, and we also provide a framework for you to customize your own instructions. So it's very powerful and can handle very many details. So you don't need to know how CPU works or how to put your things combined with the CPU pipeline. You can use the tool. Okay, we provide a full development environment from IDE and also to boards and debugging adapters and the software stack, and also we collaborate with our partners to provide the whole solutions for your development needs. And the advantages we differ from others, the first, we provide better RTL code, so it's human readable. You can feel good and you can modify or change something you want. And we also provide many useful features we figure out from our customers and the past decade. So some like misalignment issues or stack safe for core density, improvement core density. Finally, combine these things from instructions to microarchitecture design to the compiler tools, we can get higher performance and a smaller core size. It's a simple comparison, so you can see, add something to make things better. So that's the concept. And we also provide a two-wire debug support, so you can minimize your pinouts and save the chip cost. Final, the development tools, we also plus many additional features, not only put things together to workable. We have many features well shaped to like project management and many advanced debugging features. Okay, let's talk about how to do instruction customization or DSA. It's a sample from a video decoder design. On the right-hand side is the pure software approach. You can config many things and do them by software with the most flexibility. And the right-hand side is the pure hardware approach. So you must hardwire the design in circuits. So between these two, there is a way to put things together into smaller blocks, but also you can keep the flexibility. So for such a condition, you can transfer some often frequently used functions into your own instruction, like to put multiply or multiply add or some divide, or like more complex functions like motion compensation, IDCT or VOD into some directly hardwired part. So this approach will keep things faster, but also keep the flexibility for the system to control the processing or control the flow. So some speed part plus some programmable parts will make the system more flexible. So that's the basic idea for the tool or for this approach. So it's a general part to treat your problem or question into the flow. So you can start from profiling your application or your basic algorithm, and you will see something are time critical, as all we call hotspots. So you may try to define them into instructions with some cycle estimation. So in this part, it can be done in software and also a pure software simulator. And then you can put another part, the RTL design, to combine these two things together. From implement the corresponding RTL code and try to use the original EDA approach to evaluate its performance, power, and area, and check these two things together to see if the requirements can be met and if any space or any possibility to improve the whole design. To finish, after finished on this design flow, you may get a result, combine both software and the hardware, put them together. So that's the framework for the CPU hardware and also software parts. There are many important parts like CPU RTL code and the instruction set simulator and also the compiler and tool chain. And for the tool, you have to write a description file to describe the instruction and also provide the concise RTL code for the hardware part. So we provide a tool called Copilot to put things together. It will generate the different parts to combine with the original parts, then they can work together. So for the verification part, we also provide test case generators. So the things can be checked well and make sure everything can work together and doing well. So there are also some details about what and this custom extension can do. For a scalar instruction, it can be single cycle or multi-cycle. For the vector parts, you can put the attribute about for loop or do while into your design. And also, you can make your own instruction entire immediately. We call it the background option. You can choose the most appropriate part. And for operands, it can share with CPU. It can come from instructions immediate field or general purpose register or share the baseline memory with CPU. And also you can customize your own memory, your own register with the width you preferred. And also for this part is very flexible for some special algorithm or design. And then the automatic generation by Copilot, it will handle all remaining interface or some housekeeping works automatically. So finally, you will get a result of your own design instructions. There is an example about how to do a multiply and add instruction. So that's the description file about you can define a house simulator things and have an estimation about its latency. And the name should be defined for this instruction, and also you can assign some parameters for this instruction and the C simulator parts. And then put your own RTL code for this instruction's in real implementation. So it's very directly can be implemented. So after that, the benefits you can see from this example, you only write the core of this operation, or we can say the whole thing. So write simulator do and write a vlog do, and you can get many benefits from this tool because many things can be auto-generated, or the housekeeping works you don't have to worry about. So the original C program will like look like this. And after you have your own instructions, it will, you need, you only need to include a header file and then call the instruction you made plus the prefix ACE. So it looked like very simple. And you can see the corresponding relations about the input and the output value. So for the pure SQL, it costs cycles. And with this approach, it will be get a speed up about 10, about 8. So for the summary, we provide CPU cores with our special extensions that will help keep flexibility and also keep the compatibility. And that will result good power performance area and the core density. And for the ACE, it can treat the trade-off between efficiency and flexibility, and also help developers to keep focus on instruction functionality, not how to combine them together. So it simplifies and ease the instruction design. And the tool help many things and keep your work more easy and simple. So that's my presentation. And you can join the foundation's activity in the booth.